Another aqueduct. How many do they need?
Are those roads down there?
I can't even see where they end.
Some things down here work, and some don't.
Perhaps to direct and assist manual reactivation of the vault, or to mislead intruders.
Great. One way to light a room. The atmosphere processor we found before didn't need all these steps. Dad just interfaced with it directly.
And it didn't work out so great.
Direct intervention was necessary in that case, but clearly unwise.
Look how high it is. Might be another gravity well. The well's sealed. Damn. Maybe we can use the conduit for emergency power, same as before. That looks like a turret. Be careful. The conduit splits and goes through each of those devices.
Interfacing may complete the circuit and allow the well to open.
Gets us to the system lockdown. Let's try. Looks like we got that turret on our side just in time! You're sure this well isn't gonna open up under us? Pretty sure! Focus on the remnants! The other console to complete that circuit.
This device appears defensive in nature. Power restored to the gravity well. The conduit leads down. Conduit fluid pressure is variable. There could be activity below.
Then let's dig deeper. Barely any dust. is this place?
Unknown. Radiation counts indicate the vault has been offline for several hundred years.
Around the time the Scourge appeared. That can't be a coincidence. Maybe the Scourge is why all this tech was abandoned? Crap, the conduit sprang a leak.
Careful! No way you can interface with the console like that.
And no fluid means no power. Damn it! Maybe that's why those devices up above were turned off. We're not turning back now. There has to be some way to fix the leak. Dead. Without the conduit, there's not even enough power for the door.
Ryder! Up here! What happened? I can't get any doors to work.
The conduit's breached!
Hey, wait! The observers were using weird laser frequencies to fix a broken wall back there. There. I can send the frequencies to your Omni-tool. Maybe they can patch up the conduit?
And... received! I'll give them a shot! The system's responding to those frequencies! Just a patch job, but it should hold!
Nice work! If it's fixed, that console should work now!
Looks like it worked.
There's even a bridge! You're a pal, Ryder!
Where are you going?
We've got to be close to the system lockdown by now. First one gets the glory!
We'll catch up, if we got that door working too. Will you look at that?
How do we get across?
Watch your step. It's still a long drop. Wait. Lance? All the way down here?
You see them too? Thought all the gravity fun had messed up my eyes.
No sunlight, no water. They should all be dead.
The source of the system lockdown may yield more information. We appear to be close.
Big breakfast.
Company!
Armor hydraulics compensating.
That fits slippery.
Gravity wells down already, and this place goes even deeper. What's at the bottom?
Let's not find out the hard way.
Too far, even for jump jets.
That is cool.
Feel that? This whole platform's resonating with something. We must be close. No question. This is the heart of the vault.
I've never seen anything like it.
All conduits converge here, Pathfinder.
That must be the lockdown console.
Any thoughts, Sam?
Unknown. Though it appears related to the lockdown, an in-depth study may reveal its purpose. The system lockdown is disabled. The vault and the atmosphere processor should return to full operation.
Ryder, you fixed the lockdown, didn't you?
The whole place is lighting up. Power readings are off the chart.
Really, really off the chart.
But if it's back online, we should be good, too.
Should we...
go!
Wise to escape, Ryder.
I know, Sam!
Door to the entrance. All-
an override.
Console is attempting surface reconnection. Vault restart is now complete.
That was... Talk about a rush!
What was that... field?
Might have been sweeping the vault, or chasing us.
An immune response? Maybe one last scrub before startup? This place is full of surprises.
We have to be more careful. That field almost disintegrated us.
But it didn't. You want to focus on that or the cool vault you just activated?
Atmosphere processor is online. Recovering last console activity.
Is that the Helios cluster?
Yeah. There we are. That's Eos.
Whoa. Did restarting the system do that?
If that light is us, then all these points could be vaults on other worlds. Dormant like this one.
Maybe. But why is there a whole network of them? What's all this for?
This tech can create observers from nowhere or ravage a whole planet. And that's just what we've seen. The bots, those plants back there, the atmosphere processors.
Back home, some corporation hit a desert world with an ice comet. They changed the atmosphere to bring rain.
To help it support life.
That first processor we saw was making things worse, but maybe it malfunctioned.
Is that what these builders were trying to do? Make worlds habitable? Even terraform a whole cluster?
Hey, look there. That's different. Maybe it's active? We've got to go see.
Sam?
Extrapolating. These coordinates lie beyond the space we have currently surveyed, Pathfinder.
Mark it on our charts. We need more to go on. Let's head up to the surface. I could use some fresh air.
Look at that sky.
How? No atmosphere processor works that fast.
If this effect is representative, Pathfinder, air and moisture patterns will show noticeable improvement. Eos could support an outpost.
A foothold. That's all we need. Just enough to begin. This remnant technology could be the key to our survival, if we can control it.
You can. Kind of. Still, wouldn't hurt to find a manual.
We've got a lead. Sam marked it on the charts down there. That site is active, whatever it is. Who knows what we'll find there.
We? You want to come along?
I want to know what makes the remnant tick. You've got a key to their technology. Or a crowbar, at least.
Welcome aboard. We'll get you a fancy job title to go over your bunk.
I only need a footlocker. Data pad, toothbrush, clean underwear, that'll do. I'll catch up with you.
Well, this will be interesting.
Now for our new outpost.
You have already logged an ideal site. Nav point noted. Updating Tempest.
The Nexus is on pins and needles, Ryder. Pods are inbound and ready.
Let's go make it happen.
fighting a Krogan.
Is that Drac?
Here you're the one to thank for clearing up the sky. Had your number all wrong.
So, the clouds parted. These Ket look pretty keeled over. Maybe us humans can pull our weight after all.
Well, you can, clearly. But there's a lot to do before I'd be that smug about it. You know what? I'm gonna ignore my gut and join up. This fight was good, and we can do it again. And before you go saying you don't need a Krogan, believe me, you do.
That's what I said.
The first colonists sent audio logs about these regions back to the Nexus.
And?
Fairwinds Basin. Lowest radiation count in the area. Little bit of hope.
Maybe more than a little. This is where we'll build our new outpost. A real beginning.
Prepping deployment order. You must choose what purpose this new outpost will serve.
The Nexus doesn't get a say?
Resources are at a crisis point. Protocol states this judgment call falls to the Pathfinder. With current supplies, you could build a military outpost, focusing on defense and militia training. Alternatively, a scientific outpost could advance the initiative's research and discoveries.
What do you think? Military outpost or scientific?
Pathfinder's call, but research is no good if we're dead. Military.
It's got to be science. Our colonists need to understand their home.
Be advised that the first outpost placed by a Pathfinder will be a statement in itself. Fair or not, your choice will represent the initiative and its intentions in Andromeda. Consider carefully.
Prioritize research and discovery. That's our foundation. And our future.
Orders prepped. Ready on your signal.
Andromeda Initiative. This is Ryder. Pathfinder.
EOS is ready for deployment.
Copy that. Outpost block inbound. And ready as hell. August Bradley, operational head for this block. Mayor now, I suppose. We're ready to make the most of what you delivered.
It took a lot of people to get us this far. That's the work you'll continue.
I hear that. Brodromos. That's what we're calling her.
They're eager. I haven't seen eager for months. Eos is far from golden. But now it's a producer. A real and reasonable first step. They think you did the impossible. The Nexus. I warned them, hoping was irresponsible. You proved me wrong, Pathfinder.
I appreciate your candor. We're all on the same side.
I wouldn't go that far. The Reality Rider? You bought us time. But one outpost on a long-shot planet won't stop us from starving. You already have a lead on something else?
The nav point. From the vault.
Now it gets complicated. The others are ready to officially sanction your efforts, to be a part of your success. We all want the initiative to succeed. But after failing for so long, no one agrees on how to do it. Be aware, that's all.
We didn't come to a new galaxy to argue about who's right.
It got us this far. Talk to Bradley. Later, we'll go over the extended job of Pathfinder. Until then, Tan's waiting on the Nexus.
Okay, but when your shuttle gets hit by...
I really hope all those scientists will be safe out here.
We came to explore and learn. That's who we are.
I keep wondering what our scientists will cook up for Eos.
Aye. You haven't got a fuel cell, have you? The quartermaster says there's plenty, but she would. Wait. Oh, shit, you're the Pathfinder. Sorry, no one said VIPs were coming by.
I'm just Ryder. Nice to meet you.
It's a pleasure to meet you, too. I'm Fox, chief engineer at your service.
What do you think about your new home?
First impressions? We've got water, clear skies for solar power, plants to farm. The Remnant are a wild card. But I hear you almost have that solved, which is amazing. And you found us a good site here. I think Eos is really going to be special.
What do you do here?
My team gets things going. Water, power, communications, everything a civilization needs. Well, not laws or a constitution, but it's easier to concentrate on those when you got a flushing toilet.
What brought you all the way to Andromeda?
There's a colony back home you've never heard of. Viridis. It failed. Hard. I grew up there watching things fall apart. When I left, I got into infrastructure, civil engineering. Boring stuff unless you've ever lived without it. I wanted to do Viridis right, I guess. And the initiative was my best chance. Thanks for asking.
What are the other outpost staff like?
Like Connor, you mean? She's pretty fun when you get to know her. Just don't get to know her over a poker game. Trust me.
Bye, Fox.
Bye. Stay safe out there.